The quest to find a mental health provider does not end. It is January 10th, and this is going to be my fourth place that I've called. A lot of the places don't take my insurance. They aren't handicap accessible. They don't treat the illnesses that I have, blah, blah, blah. I've been run off the phone by receptionists. I've just been treated like absolute shit. So I'm going to call the Waterbury Adult Behavioral Health and see what they tell me. So I'm going to call right now.
Waterbury Hospital Behavioral Health. If this call is an emergency, please hang up and dial 911. Please listen carefully to the following selections as our menu has changed. For an inpatient psychiatric admission, press 1. For geriatric services, age 60 and over, press 2. For our adult behavioral health program, press 3. For the adolescent program, press 4. For addictions... Thank you for calling the Adult Outpatient Behavioral Health at Waterbury Hospital. If this call is an emergency, please hang up and dial 911. For referrals to the program, press 1. To make a payment or if you have questions about your bill, press 2. If you are an existing patient and need to make or change an appointment, press 3. For medication renewals or questions about your treatment, press 4. For therapist Craig Mandola, press 5. For therapist Sarah Starbird, press 6. For therapist Allison Modica, press 7. For all of the calls, press 0 or stay on the line. To repeat this menu, press star.
All of our representatives are busy assisting other callers. Please hold for the next available representative.
You have reached Grandview Behavioral Health of Waterbury Hospital. If this is an emergency, please hang up and dial 911. Our hours are 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Please leave a message and someone will return your call as soon as possible. Bye-bye.
Hi, my name is Emily Botnick. I'm 20 years old and I live in Naugatuck, Connecticut. I was just wondering if you could tell me a little bit about your program and how it works. I'm currently in search of a mental health provider. I have cerebral palsy, like I said, so I use a wheelchair, so whatever I do, the space needs to be wheelchair friendly. I have anxiety, depression, OCD, PTSD, and that's it. Yep. Anxiety, OCD, depression, PTSD. I'm also looking to get a psychiatric service dog to help with panic attack disruption and PTSD flashbacks and deep pressure therapy and item retrieval for my cerebral palsy. I've tried to get a therapist for about a month now. I have like 3 calls into 3 separate places, but nobody seems to answer the phone, and I would just like some help. That's all. Again, I'm 20, I have Connecticut, but most of Connecticut isn't covered by mental health at all, but like I said, I really want to do this, so my out-of-pocket doesn't matter. I get Social Security disability, if that makes a difference. Not that I'm not willing to pay, but if that makes a difference, and I am 20, like I said, so I'm over age. And I've heard from some people how it's like a partial hospitalization. Like you go for like 6 weeks and it's like you know, group therapy and pet therapy and whatever from like 8 to 4 in the 4 in the afternoon. Is that kind of how it works? And again, I probably would be taking the Waterbury paratransit to wherever this location is. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Feel free to call me back, Emily Botnick, age 20, anxiety, depression, OCD, and anxiety, depression, OCD, PTSD, and yeah, cerebral palsy too. My number is 203-592-1757. Thank you and have a wonderful day. Goodbye. Oh my Jesus Christ. Nobody thinks that this is a fucking... Everybody's like, oh, if this is a medical emergency, hang up and dial 911. But you know what? I really don't want to go to the hospital. I just want some fucking therapists. That's it. Fuck you, Malloy. And fuck you, Trump. Because you make it very hard to get any sort of mental health care because you don't want to pay for it. So fuck you. A big fuck you to everything. God darn it.